Hello. Would you consider yourself a positive person? Are you a positive person? Do you look for the good in things? Do you look for the silver lining? Like me, are you a silver lining detective? Think about that. Do you use your positivity to basically protect you from negative feelings? My name is Terry Cole. I'm a licensed psychotherapist. I'm a relationship expert, and I am the founder of the Boundary Bootcamp coming in September 2017. So keep your eyes open. In the meantime, shall we talk about positivity? I think we shall. I was interviewed by one of my friends, Julie Santiago, and on Facebook, you guys can join her free group, which is amazing, and it's called the Gratitude Circle. And I shout out to her because I really love her work and we're pals and she's great. But we had this really deep hour and 15 minute interview talking about a lot of things. But one of the things that we talked about that I thought was super interesting was this whole notion of being addicted to positivity. And I feel like in my younger life, before I was more psychologically healthy, positivity was the way that I got by. But the reason why it's concerning, and I work in this world of empowerment and inspiration, and you know, for years we've been reading online that it's the power of positive thinking, right? That's the key to your happiness. You even have positive psychology that's out now that, you know, if you don't get a hold of your negative thoughts, then that's gonna, you know, the secret made us all paranoid to have a negative thought. We were like, oh my God, am I creating something awful in my life because of this, right? So definitely, obviously, there are benefits to keeping an optimistic attitude. That, listen, of course, that's true. I mean, that's super easy. There's tons of psychology books on this. It's not so hard. So positive thinking, sure, it's an effective coping mechanism. We're going to agree to that. But if it's used as a spiritual bypass, right? Do you know what that is? Spiritual bypass, where you don't want to have a hard conversation. So it's like you talk yourself out of how you're actually feeling. So you're actually feeling pissed off about something, but you're like, I just need to be more spiritual. I just need to be more patient. I don't want them to think I'm a bitch. I don't want them to think I'm mean. And the truth is, so much of the time I would find with my clients is that they didn't know how to deal with it. So instead they were like, it's no big deal. So it is a big deal, right? It's a big deal if you're upset about something, but you're not doing it. Same thing with positive, you're not doing anything about that with positive affirmations, right? People think that positive affirmations are so great. Well, if you don't change anything else in your life, and if you don't have any feelings that go along with that, that doesn't help you. So the downside of being overly positive is that it can be used as a spiritual bypass, which does not help your evolution, right? It can also encourage magical thinking, right? Like unsound decision-making from being overly positive. Now that sounds crazy because if you guys actually knew me in real life, I'm super positive. I really am. But I feel like I've also lived enough to know how life is, you know what I mean? And being super positive about something, I don't use positivity as a form of denial, but I feel like you could. So that's what I'm talking about, is not using it as a form of denial. If you let something go, really because you're okay with it, that's fine. If you let something go and say it's no big deal because I'm trying to be positive, because you don't know how to have the hard conversation or you don't want to have the hard conversation, that's a problem, right? Because that's going to build up resentment, which is what it does. And I think that too much optimism, right, it's like it gives you the illusion of control, right? It's like makes you feel like you're doing something even though you may not be doing something now. I think if you have an optimistic attitude, you are raising your vibration in life because we're all energy, and I firmly believe this to be true. So having an authentic positive attitude, like, hey, My feeling is I see an obstacle as an opportunity, and that's the truth. It's how I run my business. It's how I run my family. It's how I run my life. Could be an obstacle. I'm like, yeah. Or it's an opportunity for us to figure this out and move on to the next. People who are more pessimistic will see, you know, we'll see the obstacle as like the end. Like, okay, I guess we can't do that. So those are different. Those are different ways of looking at it. But you don't want to have the illusion of control. You know, it's something that they talk about with pathological gamblers, like that they can fall prey to like this illusion of control. They believe that by adhering to, they've got their superstitions, they're going to knock on this, they find a pretty lady in a red dress, and that's going to, then they're going to like kill it at the crap table or whatever it is. And that is an illusion, right? Because maybe you get lucky and maybe you don't. And, you know, where's all the rest of your money? Do you know what I mean? So, what else about positivity? My whole thing is I want you to live authentically. And so if you're using positivity to avoid speaking truthfully, then you're not living authentically. So I want you to just think about this. This video is really sort of like food for thought about what it is that you're doing in your life. And if you do this, and why would we do this? I mean, listen, it is a defense mechanism, but if you do it too much, it puts you in that category of being in denial. So what is the balance? And let's talk about how do we find the balance between being positive and sort of like a go-getter and being able to say, hey, I see this as an opportunity, and being in denial. How do we find that balance? And I think that the healthier you get around communication, which is why I created my boundary bootcamp, so people can learn how to draw boundaries with ease and speak their truth authentically and easily. Because when you do that, you don't need to use positivity or hyper-positivity, as we'll call it, to make you feel better about not having a conversation that you need to have. Because a lot of times this hyper-positivity, it gives us a whole bunch of lies that we tell ourselves that we believe about. We stay in relationships too long, right? We stay in friendships that are not healthy for us. This hyper-positivity really is a fear-based thing, is how I see it. And I think that there's a way to find the balance. When you know who you are, you got to do your work in life, right? You've got to unpack all the crap from your childhood that is still impacting you today. Get a therapist if you had a really rough, if you had a lot of early childhood loss or abuse or whatever it is, right? You can do that. That's your right to do that. And if you don't have the money, you can go online and there's all kinds of free stuff out there. All my stuff is free online, right? You can learn a lot of things about yourself, because then you won't need to use this hyperpositivity. I also find that when people are using the hyperpositivity to like get through life, that they're the people who send you a note, an email, that's like, oh, hey, Bob, I understand that you didn't actually do the thing that I asked you to do. So it'd be really, really great if you could do it now. Smiley face. Do you know what I mean? Like there's a passive aggressiveness that comes with the denying of how they really feel, which is it's way more authentic to say, hey, Bob, I heard from so-and-so you actually didn't do what I asked you to do yesterday. Can you please tell me why? Or whatever it is. But basically writing an email or a text that's basically saying F you and then putting a smiley emoji on the end of it doesn't actually make it not say F you. You get what I mean? But it's confusing and it is giving all of these mixed messages, which is what we don't want to do. So I'm going to give you a questionnaire that you'll be able to download that's attached to this. So just if you're watching this, you can, there'll be a link somewhere in the copy that you can just fill out the questionnaire to see, are you hyper positive, smiley face, and some ideas of what you can do about it. Because what I want for you guys is a really healthy balance of like living your life, a real life. Sometimes we're sad. Because another negative thing that this does is that it vilifies anger or sadness or grief. It's like my hyper positive friends just want me to be done. Oh, don't cry. Why? Why not cry? This is a part of life. I'm sad, right? I had a death in my family less than a year ago. My 18-year-old niece was killed. I'm still sad. And I certainly have friends who are like, oh, ugh. Like I could see how uncomfortable they are if I cry about it. And I'm like, hey, man, this is, you don't need to fix my feelings. Like my feelings are fine. Clearly, your feelings about either death and dying or me not being perfect is what the problem is. I'm not sure what the problem is there. But for you guys, you want the balance of having all of those experiences because you cannot be living a healthy life if you're not experiencing all of those things. Anger, sadness, joy, sorrow, right? This is life. So I hope you like this video on hyper positivity. And I hope that you will get yours in check if you have that. If you have not joined my community and you are a woman, please do. TerryCole.com/RLR. I also have a podcast where I talk about similar stuff as to what I talk about on here. So it's called Hello Freedom with Terry Cole. So check that out. And hey, you guys, if you like this channel, if you like what I'm putting out there, please help me spread the mental health word, the positivity, not the hyper positivity, because you know what? We need to be empowered right now. And I want to reach as many people as I possibly can. So please subscribe to the YouTube channel and get in on the conversation. I answer every question myself, you guys. That is not someone else, because no one else is a therapist on my team but me. So if you write me a question, I am personally writing back to you. And because I super appreciate you being here. I don't feel entitled to your time. So thank you. I hope you have an amazing week. And as always, take care of you.